Excited to go over this webinar. We've been spending quite a bit of time doing SEO over the last few years, and I've got some pretty exciting kind of case studies that I think you'll find really interesting and probably pretty helpful in terms of finding new patients. So I titled this Three Practices That Doubled Their Patients with Google Maps. And the way that I'm going to go about the webinar is I'm going to describe a little bit about how Google Maps works, how the rankings work, and then we'll go into some case studies on that. So we'll go ahead and get started. Give me 1 second. All right, make sure my slides are working. Okay, so just a little bit about my social practice if you're not familiar with our company. We've been in the business of dental marketing for about 12 years. We started primarily as a social media marketing company. We did that for many, many, many years. Kind of like we've got the absolute best social media marketing service that you could imagine. And we work with a lot of the industry leaders out there in the dental industry. We've got quite a following in the industry. So if you're not following us on say Facebook or Instagram, you probably should, because we often sending out complimentary free stuff all the time, free downloads, trainings, tools, tips and tricks, things like that. So please follow us if you're not. Outside of social media, we do three other services. And I'm not going to spend a lot of time on this, but I just want, most people don't know that we do reputation management, which is basically helping to improve the reputation of a dentist online, a dental practice online. We have a phenomenal website service, and Google Maps SEO is what we're going to be talking about today. So we call it Google Maps SEO. That'll make sense as we get into the webinar, but that's our SEO service. One other thing that we do annually is we host the dental industry's only dental digital marketing conference. And this is something that we've done in person for several years. Sometimes we've done them online. This next year in April, we're going to be hosting it here in Utah at the UltraDent offices in South Jordan or Sandy, I think. And you can go to dentalmarketingconference.com and check it out. It's going to be just a ton of great, like, cutting edge digital marketing, dental digital marketing tips and tricks. And the presentations are TED style. They're short, quick, and you can get 8 hours of CE credit. So feel free to go check it out, dentalmarketingconference.com. We'd love to see you there. And let's go ahead and get started on what is Google My Business. So Google My Business, when you do a search on the internet, if there's any kind of a local aspect to that search, then Google will give you a map result, like this result here. So this was a dentist in Los Angeles is the search that I did. And then I just took a screen grab of the screen. So you've seen this, right? The map has the pins in the map and then the listings right below the map. This is Google My Business. And it's basically the business directory or Google's business directory within their database, okay? Now, when you do a search that isn't specifically for the name of your practice, so you're just searching something like dentist near me or something like that, the map comes up like this. But if you search the name of your practice, you'll also get what's called the knowledge graph, which is this on the right-hand side. You've probably seen this when you've tried to search for like a restaurant or something like that. When you search the name, it doesn't give you a bunch of listings for other companies. If you're on spot with the name, if you typed it incorrectly, Google's gonna find that listing and it's going to pull up the information. But the information for the knowledge graph here and the information that shows up in the map all come from what's called your Google My Business account, which is your business listing. Okay, it's not coming from your website, which is a common misunderstanding. So why is it important? Well, it's important because patients are using the Google Map more than anything, or I should say consumers are using the Google Map more than any other search result to find local businesses, okay? So through some research studies done by Search Engine Land, Bright Local, and some other companies, which are big search marketing companies, I pulled some data out of some these studies that they've done. So at the when you do a search, so this is a search for dentist in Salt Lake City, right? Usually what you're gonna see when you do a local search like that is you'll see some ads at the top, which is what I've circled here. And you know that those are ads because they say ad next to them, right? Below the ads, you usually have the map, right? Google My Business listings. And then below the map, you have what are called organic listings or website listings, rankings, okay? So you've got ads, the map, and then below that, you've got your organic listings. And these numbers that I have over here, 10% versus 68% versus 27%, has to do with the the measurable trust that people have or consumers have in the results, in those three sections of results. You can probably see this with your own search habits. When you look for a local business, you probably skip the ads. Most people do. And you go to the Google Maps section. The Google Maps section is pretty powerful because it gives you not only a visual grid of where this place is located, but you also see reviews and you get a phone number and you get an address all right there. You don't have to click on anything. So all the information's right there. So because of that, more and more consumers are using Google Maps to find local businesses rather than the ads or the organic listings. And this is well documented in just like online search consumer studies. So what you want to do as a dental practice, and what you should know is that if you want to be found on the internet, the best place to start would be to try and optimize and rank higher in the Google Map, okay? And in order to really be found, you have to be one of the top three listings. The map only has three listings on the front page. Years ago, it used to be seven, but they removed that about 7 or 8 years ago. So if you're not one of the top three listings, then you're probably not getting any phone calls through Google Maps from potential new patients. The data shows that when someone does a search for a local business, approximately 92% or more, so quite high, almost everybody will find a result on the front page. They don't click to the second page. They don't click in and scroll down and whatnot. They go to the front page and they find a result and then they take an action right there. So really what you have to do if you want to really shine in your area, you got to get into the top three listings of the Google Map. So focus on Google My Business is the point of me kind of introducing this. Most people are using the Google Map to find local business, and you need to be on the front page. So let me talk a little bit about how the rankings are determined. Okay. And then we're going to go into, we're going to unpack it a little bit. I'm going to show you some really clear examples about how the ranking system works. So Google, this is according to Google, they have three metrics that they generally use in their algorithm: relevance, distance, and prominence. Okay. So relevance has to do with the search phrase that the person is using: dental implants near me, family dentistry, inexpensive, whatever. Right? Any kind of a search phrase related to what your Google My Business account is optimized for, what it's tagged as. So when Google looks at the account, they can look at the information in the account and they can make a determination about whether or not, you know, you're a dentist, an orthodontist, you're a, you know, an auto parts store, whatever it might be. And there's a lot of things that you can do to the account to optimize that. Okay. So you want to make sure that you have, your account optimized for the phrases that are most likely to bring in patients, right? So you want a correlation between, or a relationship between search phrases and what your Google My Business account is tagged as. The second thing that determines how you rank is the distance. The distance, not just the distance of where your practice is or where your practice is located, but the distance from which the person who is searching is located compared to your practice. So, and I'm going to go into some detail on this in just a second, but basically where someone searches from, where they're physically located, has an impact and changes the rankings. So the way to think about it is if somebody's really, really far away, it's going to be very difficult for you. It's going to be more difficult for your practice to show up in the top three listings, okay, than if they're closer. That's a general way to think about it, okay? But that location issue is a big part of the algorithm, okay? And then the last thing is prominence. And prominence has to do with the strength of your Google My Business account. Do you have lots of links to it or links out of it? Are you posting? Do you have lots of photos uploaded? Are you getting reviews? Your Google My Business account mentioned on your website multiple times? And is it linked back and forth? And are there other places on the internet that have links to your Google My Business account? So there's a whole bunch that goes into prominence in terms of how to build the strength of the weight of your Google My Business account so that it appears to be more relevant than, say, another practices. And we'll talk a little bit about some of those things, okay? All right, so let's talk a little bit about relevance, distance, and prominence and how it actually functions. So the rankings in Google Maps are not static, meaning if you're here, you don't rank in a perfect circle around your practice, okay? It really has to do, these three factors, relevance, prominence, and distance, really kind of shift the map a little bit. So I'm gonna show you, I'm gonna give you an example of my town. So this is actually Draper, Utah, and this is a really good example. I did this yesterday. I live in that little circle down there at the bottom, okay? That's where I live. I live in a place called Suncrest in South Salt Lake in Utah. And we drive down the mountain and to the north to get into town. And that town there is Draper. That's the city, okay? So if I were to do a search from my house that says dentist near me, you would think that these four dental practices that are closest to me, that you've got Spangler and Tullis, Windsor Marcus, Jeffrey Welch, and Matthew Smile Dental. This other two red pins that are kind of close is a staffing company, and then the other one is an orthodontist, okay? So you would think that if I do a search, dentist near me, family dentist near me, whatever it may be, that one of these four practices is gonna come up on the map, right? Because they're physically the closest to where I'm actually searching from. So what I did is I did searches, dental. So what I've done here is I've done eight different searches and I've done a screenshot of the map, okay, of the search. So dental cleaning near me, dental clinic near me, best dentist near me, dental implants, family dentist, emergency dentist, dental crowns, okay? And when you look at the listings of who's in there, there's only one of those four practices listed one time on the front page, Jeffrey T. Welch. And nobody's gonna call him because he doesn't even have any reviews. So who knows what's going on there. So why is that, right? Why in the world would that be the case? So when you look at the listings though, there is one particular practice that shows up more than all the other practices. And it's this company, Draper Parkway Dental. Okay, they show up four times, 50% of the time on those search phrases, right? So where in the world is Draper Parkway Dental? It's 3 miles further away than any of those other practices. It's 7.6 miles from my house. The other practices are about 4.5 miles, which is about how long it takes me to get down into the valley. So what gives, right? Like, why in the world would Google rank a practice that's almost twice as far away when I'm searching near me, okay? That's the power of optimizing your Google My Business account, okay? This is what we're getting into. You can actually make this GMB, we call it a GMB account, make your GMB account rank really, really well in a wide radius, which just brings in the phone calls, okay? So I did a little bit more research on this, and instead of doing near me searches, I did dental clinic in Draper, Utah. So I actually used the city, the geographical phrase, right? Because when consumers search, they're going to search probably dentist near me or dentist in my city or town or something like that. So they're either going to be using a geographical phrase or not. So I thought I'd check and see how well these other four practices were ranking in the city. So I did dental clinic in Draper, Utah, family dentistry in Draper, Utah, dentist in, best dentist in, dental implants in, emergency dentist in, dental crowns in, dental veneers in. Okay. And what did we get? He shows up, the dental, Draper Parkway Dental shows up seven of the eight searches on the front page. And of the other four practices that are right near me, they don't show up anywhere. Okay. So Draper Parkway Dental has done some optimization. That's the reason why they're ranking so well. Okay. So 11 out of the 16 searches that I did, Draper Parkway Dental shows up on 11 of them. And of those other four practices, it's only one time, which is kind of pathetic, right? So let me unpack this even a little bit more and show you how this works. So this is VP Dental. They're a client of ours, and they are down in North Carolina. They're in North Raleigh. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to kind of like break down and show you how these rankings will shift, and then I'm going to give you some cool stuff that you can take a look at to help you guys start ranking better. So if I were to stand, so they're located right dead center of the screen, right under that big red pin, okay? If I were standing where that lady's at, which is about a half a mile west of their location, and I pulled my phone out and I did a search for dentist, which is what this search phrase is, if you look up there in the search bar. And then I counted down in the Google Maps section, VP Dental is number two. So they're the second listing on the front page. But if I go a half a mile northeast of their location where this gentleman's at, and I do the same search, dentist, they come up 13th. Now, why is that? They're both a half a mile away, right? So the only way to, what that means is that it's not, your rankings aren't in a circumference. They're not equal in all directions. They shift according to the population, the competition, how your account is optimized for different parts of the town. There's a lot of reasons for this, okay? The only way to really figure out, or I should say the question that you should be asking yourself is, well, how do I know where my practice is ranking? You know, you can go and sit down at your computer in your office and search dentist near me. And if you don't show up, number one, because you're in your office, you should call us, okay? And so we can help you out. But that's not giving you any understanding about where you're ranking outside of your office. Nobody's going to search your practice if they're sitting in your practice, right? You need to be able to be found if you're a mile away, this way or that way, or 2 miles away, or whatever it might be. So the question you have to ask yourself is, where am I already ranking? Like, if I go to this neighborhood and I did a search for dentist, am I showing up on the front page of the map or not? And the only way for you to do that is to literally get your phone out, drive around town, and do the searches, which nobody's going to do because it takes too long and it's almost kind of ridiculous. So we figured out another way to do it to make it easier, is what I'm getting at. So what we have here is we have a piece of software that allows us to put in a latitude and a longitude and a search phrase, and then we run the search, and then it counts down in the Google Maps listings to see where a particular practice is located, okay? So if you look dead center in this graph, you'll see right between the two images of the lady and the man, there's a number two. That is the latitude, that's their practice location, okay? So we took the latitude and the longitude of their practice location, and we ran a search for the word dentist, and they came up number two. That's why the little circle says number two on it, okay? And then we went a half a mile north, a half a mile east, south, and west, and did the same thing. And then we went another half a mile north, south, east, and west, and did the same thing. So we ran 169 different searches, and we counted down in every single one of the searches to see where they're ranking, whether they're ranking on the front page of Google or not. And you remember, you got to be in the top three to be on the front page. So what you get is you get this funky kind of grid, right? We call this a radius report or a Google Maps report. But you can see there the little, I call these nodes or circles. You've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So they are six. They've got six positions, little singular positions, where they're on the front page. It's either a one or a two or a three. Everything out around there, they're not ranking on the front page of Google. And like I mentioned before, over 90% of people are gonna, if they're looking for a new dentist and they're going online, they're probably gonna make a decision on one of the listings on the front page, most likely. So you can run this grid report for different phrases. So not every single practice ranks the exact same pattern for, say, dentists as they do for dental implants. So this is VP Dental's dental implant grid. Okay, so in the center, dead center is a number nine. They're not ranking very well for dental implants. If you're standing in their office and you search dental implants near me, they come up number nine. That's not good, right? So they need some help with this particular phrase. So every single phrase can change. It can have a different graph depending on who's trying to optimize their listings for those certain phrases. So the question that you've got to ask yourself at this point is like, well, what should this look like, right? Should I be able to rank all over the place? Is this good? Is this bad? What's good or bad? And it just takes a little bit of time and energy to figure that out. But for this particular practice, we optimized them for cosmetic dentists, okay? They wanted cosmetic patients. So that's what we started with one keyword, and that's what we focused on. And we got them to the point where they were ranking beyond, this is about 3.5 to a 4 mile radius about. If you count from the center, every one of those little nodes is a half a mile. It's about 1, 2, 3 miles northeast, south, or west. Might be probably about 3.5, maybe 4 at the corners. So they're ranking almost on the front page within at least a 3.5 to 4 mile radius, right? So when you get when you can optimize a particular phrase, a keyword for this range, this is kind of like the litmus test, or maybe that's not the right vernacular. This is kind of like your go-to map. Like, you should be able to get the other phrases eventually to rank similar to this. Okay, I'm gonna show you some more examples of that. Okay, but basically, these grid reports and the rankings change based on pressure points and so forth, and also the different phrases that you're trying to rank for. So thanks, but how does this grow my practice? So all of this ranking stuff, really, what does it mean in terms of dollars, right? Like, how many phone calls are actually going to come in if I'm ranking green for cosmetic dentist versus if I'm not? So the good thing about Google Maps is that it tracks all of this. And so I'm going to go through three case studies and show you basically what's happened with the grids, the reports, And then the actual numbers of new phone calls and clicks to the website and so on and so forth, okay? So I'm gonna show you a pediatric practice, a dental practice, and then I'm gonna show you an endodontic practice to give you kind of a range of different specialties. So this is Dr. Ball. She's in Rockville, Maryland. And when we started working with her, on the left there, day one, and this is for the word children's dentist. You can see that at the right in the top at the middle there. Keyword is children's dentist. So we ran the report. And so that's the one here on the left. And I just counted up the number of little nodes that she's on the front page for to kind of give us a measurement of how well she's ranking. And it really doesn't matter, I would say, in terms of getting phone calls, if you're fifth or sixth or seventh or eighth. If you're not on the front page, you just probably aren't going to get as many phone calls. So we really only want to count how many, where is this practice ranking on the front page? So she had seven of those dots. She was ranked on the front page. At day 90, 102. Okay, so huge expansion in terms of ranking. Another 90 days, so it's 6 months in, 116 she's now ranking for. Now you can see that there's a big jump in day one to day 90, and not as big of a jump between day 90 and day 180. And that's because you can't rank forever, right? You can rank almost every single practice I've looked at has a lot of room to grow for many, many keywords. But you can't just keep growing and growing and growing forever, because at some point the location function is just, you know, if you're ranking 50 miles away, nobody's going to click and come to your office. And so Google's going to realize that, and you're not going to be showing up there. So you can kind of see as the months go on, you can basically see, oh, okay, well, you know, we're kind of hitting the limit with this particular phrase. That doesn't mean you stop optimizing. You continue to optimize for it, and which there's a whole bunch of tactics and so forth that you can do to optimize, which I'm not going into today. We've done several webinars on that as well, tips and tricks on how to do it. If you're interested, just give us a call. We'll send you the videos and whatnot. But you basically get to a point where, you know, you kind of like max out your opportunity for that particular keyword. So this is the second phrase that we worked on with her, which is pediatric dentist. On day one, we had 41 positions on the front page. She was ranking much better for pediatric dentist than she was children's dentist. After day 90, we had 108. Day 180, 110. You can kind of see the same growth. It kind of like went up quick, and then kind of tabled off at 110. Okay. Now I did, this is kind of a cool thing. What I did is I basically took these grid reports and I mapped them over the top of each other, because I wanted you to see how the optimization grows month over month over month. So I'm just going to play this and you can kind of see what happens. So you can see that starts to go green in the middle and kind of grows. See how it's growing green? The red's getting pushed out. It's just going to repeat. I'm going to let this play a couple times. So the first grid, it's all jumbled and messed up. And that's because there was really no optimization that had gone on. And so Google wasn't sure where they wanted to optimize for. So as soon as you begin the optimization, it kind of coalesces. And for her, in her area, if you're familiar with the area, it's kind of a north, west to a southeast line in terms of the population. So she actually grows to the northeast and the southwest better. She gets more pressure from the top left and the bottom right, because that's where the population centers are. So you can kind of see the red stays in there at the corners and the top left and the bottom right. And that's just because it's more competitive. So everybody's different in terms of how they rank. But the optimizations, you can see, takes hold, and it, you know, she starts to rank at a wider radius, okay? All right, so what is this in terms of statistics. So organic views. So what I did, so in these stats I'm going to show you, what I did is I took the 3 months prior to us working with her office, and I looked at the stats in her Google My Business account, okay? And I just got the data, and then I counted up the stats after the first three months of working with us, okay? In terms of the optimum, so to see, show you, you know, kind of what was she doing on average prior, and then how did things go afterwards. So organic views are the website results. So the results below the map, not in the list, not in the Google My Business account, but the website links. We don't really, what was interesting about this is when we started optimizing Google My Business accounts, we didn't know that we were going to get organic results going up, but she went up 340%. So she had 2,300 views versus almost 8,000. What that means is that someone has done a search, probably right around her area, and she showed up on the front page of Google. So her doesn't mean they clicked on it, doesn't mean they called her office. It just means that she showed up. So this is the first metric that you look at when you're measuring the quality of your SEO, like how many times do people have the opportunity to see me, right? So organic views went up almost 340%. I forgot I put this graphic in here. So these are the listings that I'm talking about below the map, okay? All right, the second stat is the Google Maps views. So how many times did she show up in the Google map when somebody did a search? So before, 3 months before, 2,400. Afterwards, 5,830, okay? So that is in this section, right? She shows up in the listings on the front page. Website visits. Now, these are website visits from Google Maps. These are not all of the people that land on her website. These are people that are finding her listing in Google Maps and clicking on it. So you see, when you pull your phone out and you do a search for a business on Google Maps, there's a website link. You can click to the website. Or if you're on a desktop, which is what this is right here I'm showing you, you can click to the website. It tracks those clicks. Okay, that's the website visits here, 190 to 374. So she almost got 200 more website clicks. And then the last stat here is calls. Same thing. In the Google Maps app, you have the ability from the mobile app, you have the ability to call directly from the app. So she went from 79 phone calls to 122. She got about 40, 43 more phone calls in 3 months directly from Google Maps. This is not counting all the people that clicked to her website and then called, right? Because it's not tracking the call of somebody pulling their phone out and then just dialing the number. It's only tracking the click to call. So these are like legit, like people click to call, okay? So I got on the phone with her because these were really good results. We had a little call and she says, I'm receiving so many new patient phone calls from Google Maps that I'm hiring a second hygienist. I love this. So she's been kind of blowing it up actually really well. She's still doing great. So that's the first client example or case study. So let me show you a dental case study. This is VP Dental. This is the one I kind of used in the example earlier about where she was ranking well for cosmetic dentist. And I'll show you some of the numbers with her. So this is for the word family dentist. Okay, so this is another one of the phrases that we optimized her for. Day one, she wasn't ranking anywhere. Zero, all those little X's. Oh, by the way, I didn't tell you this, but the reason it says X and not a number is because we only go 19 deep. We only count 19 deep. As soon as we hit 20, we just put an X and stop counting. So when it's an X, a little white X and a red dot, then that just means that, who knows, they could be 20th, they could be 100th, we're not sure. So, and really it doesn't really matter at that point to know exactly how deep you are. So Anyway, only cap down to 19. That's why it says X. So zero on day one after day 60, you had five. So she's not ranking nearly as fast as Dr. Ball, the previous example, right? We optimized really quickly with her and wide, and that has a lot to do with the area and the competition in the area. She's right on top of Raleigh, and Rockville, Maryland is not nearly as competitive as Raleigh. And then day 90, we had eight, okay? Now that doesn't seem like a huge impact, right? Going from zero to eight. But, and then let me show you this grid. I did the same thing with her as well for family. So this shows you actually how family dentist optimized over time. So let me show you. See how it goes from 5, 3, 1, 3. So it optimizes slower, but eventually we get to there. So this is actually more than the first 6 months. This is like the first year of the optimization, okay? But it's interesting how it kind of grows from the center out. So here's what happened. Optimizing her for cosmetic dentist and family dentist, she's worked there at the office. This is Donna, the office manager. She's worked there for at least a decade, I think. They get an average of 10 new patients a month. After we started the optimization, within like a month to 2 months, they were getting almost double new patients, and they've consistently been able to do that. So I called her, and this is what she said. She said, within the first 3 months, we doubled our new patients. We've tried so many different SEO services, but this is the first service where I've actually seen new patients. I highly recommend Google Maps SEO to any practice looking to grow. We would not be where we are without their help. So that's Valerie. And then let me show you this last one for H.H. Hancock. So this gentleman is an endodontist, and this was kind of an interesting case. This is for the search phrase endodontist, day one. On the left, you can see we have 11 positions on the front page. After 6 months, we have 167. And then it was different with him. An endodontist has a wider, there's not as much competition as a dentist. And so we found that we could actually go pretty wide, a lot wider than we would with a regular dentist. So this last graph on the right, what I've basically done is there's a mile between each one of those little nodes, not a half a mile. So it's twice the size. So the middle graph is really that internal section. And you can see that down to the southeast, he's ranking on the front page way down into that area through Raleigh. So we have the ability to adjust the map according to, we can run those latitudinal, longitudinal points, based on a half mile grid, a mile grid, 0.25 mile grid, and we'll adjust that according to the area that we're in to kind of see how well somebody's ranking. So the bigger the map, obviously, the wider your ranking is, the smaller the grid, that's just a more focused area. So that was endodontist. And then here's root canal, which are the two main phrases for endodontics, right? So day one, he had four listings in the Google Map 3-pack. By day 180 at 169, and then day 365, he had you can see he's ranking all over the place in about a 12 mile circumference. And he goes out quite a ways. I've run some grid reports that are even like twice that size. I don't really put them in the presentation, but he ranks pretty well. In quite a wide range. Now, here's what's interesting about Dr. Hancock. So he's been in business for like 20 years. And when we started working with him, here. So this is timeline is an 18-month timeline. And we've been working with him for about a year. So we started in, actually a little over a year now. So we started in right at the beginning of September, right at the end of October, maybe last week of October-ish. And that's where that red line is at. And what you see is you see a downward slope, right? So the question was like, well, what are you guys doing? These are, his views are going down on maps. What are you doing? Well, the crazy thing about this doctor is his Google My Business account was optimized for dentists. So he was ranking well for dentistry, but he doesn't do dentistry, he does endodontics, right? So we had to like totally revamp his Google My Business account and optimize it for the right phrase, dentist, or excuse me, endodontist. And that's what that downtick is. It took us like 3 months to get Google to kind of recognize that. And then starting in January, it started to pick up and started ranking higher endodontics. So what happened is he was being, now he's being seen as much or more as he was when he was a dentist, but he's getting the right kinds of searches, right? He's ranking for the correct phrase. So he's getting more phone calls. Connie, the office manager, said, after we began Google Maps SEO, our practice started seeing a significant uptick in new patients. We started getting calls from GPs that had never referred to us before. I love this service. We've been in business for 20 years and we've never been number one until now. Okay. So here is, I had a couple more of these GIFs, these little videos that I wanted you to see because they're kind of interesting. This is Dr. Ratana. He is an associate dentist who started at basically a new practice right next to the practice that he was working in down in Irving. And this is what happened with his group report. So this is a scratch practice, prosthodontic practice. And this phrase is dental implants in Irving, Texas. See that? Kind of interesting. Kind of grows to the north and then the east or west and then kind of. And then here's a, this is an interesting one. This gentleman's in Brooklyn. And I was really excited when I saw this because Brooklyn is not easy to optimize for. It's so compact up there in New York. So here's what happened with him. You can see he's ranking really well out in the ocean, but excuse me. I'm just joking there. You know, it doesn't really matter if you're ranking in the ocean, but you can see it's the pressures up north where the population is, right? So you're probably asking yourself, how are you currently ranking? Like, how are you like ranking currently right now? So what we can do, complimentary, we are happy to run some of these ranking reports for you. And so let me show you how to do that. If you hold your phone up to that QR code, it will take you to a little landing page where you can request a free Google Maps ranking report. It's gonna ask you for your name, your mobile, and the name of your practice, and your email so we can get a hold of you. I'll somebody give you a call. You can tell them the phrases that you want us to run the reports on. We'll go run the reports. We'll give you a call back and explain what everything means, how wide we wrote, we made them. And if there's some interesting stuff, we'll run some additional reports. Or if you guys have more than one or two or three phrases you want to do, we're happy to do the research. The more you look into this, the more you realize that you could probably really improve your growth, the growth of your practice through optimizing for Google My Business. So just go to that QR code. You can also just call us if you want to just give us a call, 877-316-7516, and just say, hey, I was sat in on Adrian's webinar and I'd like to get some grid reports. And we'll get that over to you and you guys can see where you're at. You might be ranking really, really well for some of the phrases. You might not. So it's always kind of interesting to see where you're at and which neighborhoods you're ranking for. Most dentists know, they know, hey, I really want to be ranking in this particular neighborhood because these are the type of patients that I want to attract, right? Whether it's a high income area or new building, new home owners, or, who knows. And this will show you like literally right down in the neighborhoods where you're ranking. And then from that, when we do the optimization, we can like target those specific areas and help that grid grow out, you know, kind of expand. So are there any questions that anybody has? You can just chat them into the Q&A if you have any questions, or if you want to raise your hand, I'm happy to answer any questions. Okay, I don't see anybody asking any questions, so I must have done a really, really good job. That or you've all fallen asleep, and that's more likely. Anyway, it was a pleasure. We'll have this recorded and posted on our blog. So if you want to go back over it again, you're welcome to rewatch it after we've got our webinar recorded and posted and whatnot. So thank you for attending. Wish you the best of luck.